Welcome back, trainers. And in this video, we're going to be going up against Arlo 4 times. This is going to be a pretty fun challenge for myself that I set out to do, in which I'm going to be going and using only 1500 CP Pokemon. We've seen that before, right? You're like, okay, what's the challenge? Well, I'm going to have to use different Pokemon every single time, and we're going to be going up against him 4 times. So that's going to be a good amount of different Pokemon. So starting it off with this one here, I do start off with the Blaziken, and then I go into the Sphylus here. This is going to be the first one. Now, I didn't go out there and hunt down specific sets of Pokemon that he does have. I just went 4 of them, like, back to back to back, and I was done. And not only that, guys, but we have a twist as well. I'm going to be getting myself a shiny. Can't believe that happened. I wasn't even on the pursuit for that. This took me many different tries for this specific set here. I wanted to get it down with these Pokemon in sync with each other. So basically what I had to do was do a few more counters in the beginning with my Blaziken, so my Sphylus can have that much more health to do a few more bites on the Blastoise, and you're going to see why here towards the end. So the Venusaur is going to come in. Now there's always this problem. I did it probably like 20 different times. The Venusaur is going to be able to almost get to this Frenzy Plant here, but then it faints out, unfortunately. I tried different combinations, but this is the one that was set here. So the Blastoise does have bites, so luckily we're going to be able to resist that with our Blaziken being that fighting type. So we're going to do counters and then get enough for that Blaze Kick and then finish it off with quick moves with enough energy to take out the Scizor here with Blast Burn. So this was quite the challenge. It was a fun one here, and I challenge you to do the same. So we take him out there and we're looking good. So for the next Arlo, we're going to have to use 1500 and under yet again, but we cannot pick any of those Pokemon here. And this is why I decided to go with these ones, because they're not really likely for me to be used again. And I wanted to see if I was able to do it in combination with each other. So we're looking great. And this Bagon is not gonna be shiny. So moving it on to the next one here. And folks, I have another video coming out for you, and it's going to be about how the game is crazy buggy. All right, anyways, moving into the next one, starting it off with the Pignite. Now, the Bagon does have Ember, so we're resisting it with the Pignite. Now, we're going to be going in here with the Altaria, also resisting the Ember on the Bagon. And we don't need to hit those bubbles because, you know, of course, they used the shields 2 times in a row. And with that Dragon Breath, we're doing a ton of damage. So at this point, of course, we're going to be using our shield. You always want to do that for the most part, going up against the Rocket Leaders. And for the next one is going to be Charizard. So it's not horrible here. We are going to be resisting that Fire Spin on the Charizard, so that's not all bad, as well as burning that last shield. Now we're looking great here. This was the first time for me to go in with these 3 Pokemon. It didn't take me several attempts for this specific set here. For the most part, because Swampert is a beast. Now in comes the Swampert. I'm using the Swampert card, cannot bring him back, and that's okay though, because there are going to be other options here. But 1500 CP, Swampert putting in work here, very squishy, but that Hydro Cannon mixed with Mudshot is devastating here. And I'm not really doing too many of the rocket stops anymore. It's getting a little bit pricey on top of Poffins and then raiding and everything. Yeah, the benefits, the rewards that you get are just really not too great, to be honest with you. You have the shiny chance, right? So we do faint down with our Swampert. In comes the Pignite here. And with that little bit of energy we did gain, we're able to get to this Fire Charge move. I forgot what it's called. Okay, Flame Charge. There we go. And we're able to take out that Scizor there. So that's another one down. A new set of Pokemon for the next one. We cannot use any of the ones that you've previously seen here. So Charizard is still on the list, thank goodness. And I also have a surprise Pokemon pick that we're going to be taking a look at that worked out quite well under 1500 CP. And that is going to be Suicune. Absolutely. Going up against the Charizard, as you will see here, I do have 2 moves. Bubble Beam, which will actually lower its attack, and then Hydro Pump for that hard-hitting damage. So we're going to be starting it off with Suicune so we can make that transition, freeze our opponent when we do go into Clefable, and then charm it down here with enough energy to burn a shield at least when that new Pokemon does arrive, because it takes a while for Charm to charge up the charge moves, right? Okay, so there goes the Charizard, and I'm sorry about the order. I mean, I wish there was more variety when I went to these Rocket Leaders. This is what I ran into, and this is what I get, right? A lot of Charizard, a lot of Scizor is like, come on, can I get a little bit of a different variety? But I can't complain too much, because you're going to see what we got here, folks. Anyways, let's go ahead and enter with the Suicune. Now, what I'm doing with these Rocket Leaders is initially entering with completely maxed out Pokemon, seeing what it does have, and then I will go in there with the set 1500 Pokemon team that I think can get the job done. Now, I don't go in there, see what it has, and if it's not to my liking, then I go away. I will complete it because finding the Arlos in general, as it is, was just kind of a pain in the butt, right? So anyways, we were able to get off a Bubble Beam, and we're going to be able to go for that Hydro Pump at this point because both the shields are down. Let's see how much damage a Suicune can do to that Charizard with this CP level. And it does a good amount, looking great. So we did lower the attack, and it is making a big difference. As you can see, we're able to stick into this fight a lot longer than we typically would have. And we're going to go ahead and bring that attack down even more with the shields down. This will be doing at least something here. And at this point, we're going to make a switch into Charizard. I don't know if that was necessary. Like I said, this is my first run through, so I don't know how another scenario would have played out. I just felt like this was the most successful route to take for me. So basically just going with the Charizard and just farm it down to a degree. I do hit this because I didn't want its charge move to get through, because at this point I believe I do not have any more shields. Yeah, okay, that's why I hit that. And then by the time the Scizor comes back, ooh, you guessed it, yay, a Scizor. And then at this point, the Blast Burn is basically going to one-shot the Scizor here. And we'll just be able to finish it off with Quick Move. So I think the most challenging one was going to be the first one. It literally came down to, like, perfect timing. A specific amount of Quick Moves with a specific Pokemon. You had to hit the charge at the perfect timing. Obviously, you could have done it with other Pokemon, but I wanted to use those combinations. Anyways, let's see what we have here, folks. Is this the one where I am going to possibly get a shiny? And it is, folks. Are you kidding me? I literally was screaming in the car. I was pretty excited because it was very unexpected. I never really get my hopes up for these shiny shadow Pokemon. If it happens, it happens. But they're so rare. You just kind of, personally for myself, when I'm doing rocket stops for the leaders, it's for a challenge. Because if I'm going to spend the $2, I want to get some sort of content out of it. And then bring it to you guys so you can, you know, have ideas as to maybe how you can make them fun for yourself as well. Obviously, we can take them out with maxed out Pokemon fairly well. This one has, looks like, 12 attack, 1 defense, and then 15 stamina. So I'm happy I'm able to even find one of these things. Made it my buddy for a minute, and it's already off as my buddy. Put back Sableye because I want to get that to best buddy as soon as possible before the Go Battle League, which I do believe is going to happen in the beginning of February or at the very end of this month, January. So really excited for that. They're even starting to tweet things out to bring the hype because they're definitely going to promote this. Now, going into the last one, this was a very close one, but it didn't take me multiple tries. I went in there, saw what the team was, picked my team accordingly for the 1500 CP, and then I was able to get it down perfect, right down to the wire. So going in with the Wigglytuff, we're not going to be doing any switching in the beginning here. We can just farm it down. Almost able to get to an Ice Beam to burn the shield. Unfortunately, I was not. So I did pick Garchomp as well as Cast Form Sunny. So I'm in a bit of a jam here. At the very end is going to be Scizor, of course, yet again. So what we're going to do here is just burn a shield. Do a few attacks. I should have took advantage and did a few of those embers there, but I switched to Garchomp, in which the Steelix is going to have Fire Fang, and so the Garchomp is going to be 4 times resisting that, so we're perfectly fine. We can farm this thing up if we want. So we burn the last shield and we're good to go at this point. And whenever the opponent does attack, I absolutely love that because, well, it's going to freeze afterwards, therefore I'm going to be able to gain energy. It's kind of like free energy or getting to a charge move a little bit earlier. So as you can see, the Garchomp is holding its own fairly well, even with that low CP up against that Thunder Fang there. So we're going to go ahead and do Earthquake. This is not going to exactly KO it, but it's going to be getting pretty close here. I felt like I could have maybe farmed it down with Quick Moves, but then this happened. It used its charge move, which is perfect. I love that as well. Not only when they use their charge move, but when you're down to a sliver of health. But unfortunately, I already hit my charge move, so I kind of wasted it there. I don't even need to hit the bubbles at this point because it's just going to faint them out anyways. And then, of course, we have the Scizor, however you like to say it, in the back here, in which we're going to switch into the cast form. This was really close. You're going to see what happens here, so check it out. And this is why whenever you do switch, it's so nice. Or not necessarily switch, but taking advantage of those little times where it does pause. So it does faint me out, but I had enough energy on my Garchomp. We're able to get to Earthquake and take the win. So hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a big thumbs up, share it with your friends who may find it interesting, and I'm going to be keeping you up to date like usual on everything Pokemon Go. And it looks like Niantic is starting to tweet out about the Go Battle League online system, so start to get hyped for it as more information does come out and as we get closer to that date. Thank you for watching, trainers, and I'll be catching you on my next video. Take care.